now we take the journey into another science deliberately, because the word consciousness arose. What is this consciousness, we ask? Let us go into the life sciences, the biological science. How do they define life? I mean, the kind of stuff I hear, and I of course like to pull my hair out, is this. Whenever science struggles, it is a habit of producing a jungle of jargon and getting lost in it. Just because it can't handle some of these kind of unusual features, it'll produce a whole jungle of jargon. You heard some, I'm sure, this morning. And you get lost and say, wow, such fantastic, but I know where I am. They say this life thing, what is this life thing? They say, well, this is a dissipative structure far from equilibrium. It's an emergent phenomena in an epigenetic complex systems of structures within structures. Make of it what you like. I'll tell you how I found the best definition of living things. It's nice to find simple ways of understanding difficult things. They say, this is how we define a living thing. Suppose you find a piece of rock, and you are in a kind of weird mood, and you want to kick the piece of rock. You go and kick it. Knowing your physics, of course you know your physics and maths, you can work out its trajectory to the nearest millimeter. So far, so good. Suppose you are in an even more weird mood, and you're walking about, and you see a dog, and you feel like... Now you see, I'm a mild-mannered Hindu who is against violence towards animals in the name of science. So I'm saying, just carry out the thought experiment. So you see a dog and you say, go for it. You know, one thing is for sure. We don't know, we can't work out the trajectory of the dog, but one thing is very likely, he'll go for your leg. I'm trying to define life in simplistic terms. This is what life is defined as in the Hindu tradition. It is not that it is something that is in compliance with the physical world that we see in front of us. It's not in compliance, it stands up against it. It is in defiance of it. This is how we define life. And in biological science, this is how they define. They say it is as if there is an autonomous structure that interacts with its environment in a selective manner. The word is selective. So it is not dictated by nature. It is at best, kind of disturbed by nature, external. It's not directed, it's not dictated by. It's just disturbed, it's going, ouch, don't do that to me. That's a living thing. The unique feature about living thing, one thing that makes it very special, is that it has got this power of cognition. Even a single cell thing is able to suss out its environment, move towards light or heat, is able to suss out, it's becoming somehow rudimentarily conscious. Cognition is the word. It seems to recognize somehow something is different, has become visible. Sometimes, in order to demolish the idea of something special, there is something special about living things, people say, we see it's artificial intelligence, Mr. Lakhani. It's nothing more than, if you like, this processing power of the brain. Something that processes information the way we define life. You might think that's a good thing, sounds nice, kind of modern age. But your laptop that you possess, each and every one of you, I'm sure, can process information a billion times faster than you ever can. What does it say about you? The computer is alive, you are dead. This is not that simplistic.